हेलो दोस्तों, वेलकम टू लिखो स्टेनो एकेडमी। दोस्तों, डेली डिक्टेशंस के लिए और आपके डाउट्स के सॉल्यूशंस के लिए इस चैनल को अभी सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल आइकन प्रेस करें ताकि आपको चैनल से जुड़ी सभी अपडेट्स रेगुलरली सबसे पहले मिल सके। दोस्तों, आज मैं आपको जीडी बेस्ट वॉल्यूम नंबर 3 से ट्रांसक्रिप्शन नंबर 47 और 48 की डिक्टेशन प्रोवाइड करूँगा। 1000 वर्ड्स की डिक्टेशन है और इसकी स्पीड मोर देन 100 होगी एज यूजुअल। आपको डिक्टेशन प्रोवाइड कर रहा हूँ, बी रेडी फॉर इट। सर, हेयर अगेन आई हैव द अथॉरिटी ऑफ द यूनियन लेबर मिनिस्टर टू से दैट इन दिस चेंजिंग कॉस्ट स्ट्रक्चर द लेबर कंपोनेंट ऑफ द कॉस्ट स्ट्रक्चर इज कमिंग डाउन। इफ द लेबर कंपोनेंट इन द कॉस्ट स्ट्रक्चर इज कमिंग डाउन, इट ओनली मीन्स दैट द worker is not getting enough or even an equitable share out of the commodities that are produced and sold in the market. If that is the case, then there is at least a prima facie case for inquiring into the wage structure and to see whether justice is being done to the workers or not. There is a further question which we have to take into account, and that relates to the capacity to pay, the capacity to the various industries to pay. I fully realize that we have to keep our eye on the various objects that are before us and that we should not go into a wrong direction by just concentrating on one objective or industry. I am prepared to go to the length of saying that if it is necessary, we should see that maximum capital formation takes place even if social objectives are for some time kept in abeyance. But having said that, I must also say that social justice cannot be denied completely merely because we have got the objective of economic development before us. We have to ultimately see that a via media is found which is good for the broad masses of our people. We cannot expect a solution for our economic difficulties by just ignoring the cause of the workers. Sir, if we look to the industries, we find that these are the very industries in which profits are accumulating very fast. There is one very sure indication of whether a particular industry is doing good or not, and that is the barometer of the share market. If we examine the price of shares in respect of the chemical industry, the engineering industry, and even the iron and steel industry, we find that these shares are appreciating in value from time to time because of speculative reasons, because of the policies of the government, and because of the credit policies of the Reserve Bank. At times there may be recession and at times there may be boom, but over a long period the value of these scrips has been rising and rising continuously. The value has been rising because, according to the economic commentators, the financial experts who write in the commercial papers owned by the industrialists of our country, the investor is sure that even if he is not getting enough dividends today, the dividends that he would like to get, he would get later on, because the capital in these industries is appreciating at a very fast rate. It is because of future gains which would accrue to him as a result of capital appreciation that he is investing in these various industries. This clearly shows that the Indian investors are fully informed. Sir, with regard to iron and steel, the position is that in Tata's, which is the major steel project, recently the workers and the employer have entered into an agreement with regard to wage increase, and that has come into force already. About the engineering industry, my friend was reading out some names saying that one has got 18 workers while another has 1800 workers. If the suggestion is that a factory employing 1800 workers should be treated at par with a factory employing 18 workers or vice versa, then certainly I am not in agreement with him. It would not be proper to cover them by one law. With regard to mines, we had a national tribunal subsequent to that. By agreement between the parties, an arbitrator was appointed, which again increased the wages of some of the categories, and we are persuading the employers to accept the award of the arbitrator and implement it. With regard to railways, posts and telegraphs, there has been the pay commission. The ports and docks also follow generally what is recommended by the pay commission. For dock workers also, we had some adjudication. The workers in the major docks are governed by a special act, and their requirements are taken care of fully so far as emoluments and other service conditions are concerned. Therefore, it should not be assumed that because no wage boards are appointed with regard to any industry, the workers have no avenue to get their claims settled through an impartial tribunal. It is true that the second plan recommended appointment of wage boards. As I have mentioned, wage boards have been appointed for certain industries. It is not as if by the appointment of a wage and by the submission of their report, all the problems are settled. On the other hand, they create problems as well, as it has happened in the case of textile industry. Government has recommended to the industry and the workers to accept the recommendations of the textile wage board. But from the south, there is a suggestion that if this is implemented, the mills there will close. That is the reason why more wage boards have not been appointed and why we are not appointing them immediately. Sir, difficulties have been created because of the wage boards which have already been appointed and the way their reports have been received in some sections. That has to be taken into consideration by the government before making their decision with regard to other wage boards. About the sugar industry, we have not yet received the report. First, we want that these wage boards should submit their reports. When these are implemented, the experience gained by working and following the reports should be before us. Parliament members also may study them, and in the light of that, further action has to be taken. Of course, as I said earlier, we are appointing wage boards for plantation and jute industries in coming days. सो दोस्तों, इसी के साथ ये डिक्टेशन फिनिश होती है. 110 वर्ड पर मिनट इसकी स्पीड थी और कुछ ज़्यादा डिफिकल्ट ये मैटर नहीं है, लेकिन वर्ड्स थोड़े थोड़े अच्छे इसमें आए हैं. आप अपनी मिस्टेक्स मुझे बताइए कि कितनी मिस्टेक्स आपकी इस मैटर में आई हैं और किस किस सेक्शन में आपको लग रहा है कि अभी भी आपको प्रॉब्लम हो रहा है तो कमेंट सेक्शन में आप मुझसे पूछ सकते हैं, अदरवाइज़ फेसबुक पे आप डायरेक्टली मुझसे बात कर सकते हैं। मैंने चैनल के होम पेज पर लिंक दिए हुए हैं, आप वहाँ से मुझसे कनेक्ट कर सकते हैं। आपसे मुलाकात करता हूँ अगली क्लास में अगली ट्रांसक्रिप्शन के साथ, तब तक के लिए बाय बाय, टेक केयर।